past the 6 month mark, so I thought that I would do a full day of eating and show everything that I'm eating throughout the day for this bulk, as most of you guys know that I'm doing for my first pro debut. But I'm super excited about it because we finally broke 190. And I've been waiting to break this number for a while. Next number is 200. It's 10 right now, and I had a little bit of a late start today. I woke up like 15, 30 minutes ago. And my coach has me doing like just quick 15 minutes of fasted cardio in the morning. Before I eat my first meal, I normally take these, by the way. So most of you guys probably aren't gonna have to take this. I did just do a video of this on my podcast channel, Transparent, about, I don't really like the title, but it was the easiest way to communicate it, but it's basically how to survive steroids, and it has 7 phases. It's a pretty long video, but most of you guys probably won't have to take this if you're not taking gear or bodybuilding, anything like that. But I start the day off with citrus, bergamot, and astragalus root, and I take it fasted before, I try to take it about 30 minutes before my first meal. So I already took that, and then I take 2 pills of this. So this is 4 capsules per serving, and I take about 1.5 servings a day. This is an organ support, so it's got like NAC, Tudka. Tudka is like extremely important. First one is 75 grams of chicken, 75 grams of salmon. I like to spray just a little bit of olive oil on it, about 2 to 3 grams. And then I pour a little bit of iodized salt just for the thyroid. But if I had a preference, normally later in the day, I go for this. Alright, so for meal one, that makes 50 grams of blueberries, 50 grams of blackberries, 70 grams of pineapples, 75 grams of salmon, sockeye salmon, and then 75 grams of chicken breast with 3 grams of olive oil, and then some nice tasty seasonings, and then a fucking cup of spinach. So, I'm sorry this doesn't look pretty. I know what you're thinking. And I also take turmeric. I forgot to mention this. My coach wants me to take turmeric, but I don't take it around my workouts just to avoid the anti-inflammatory effect, since you do want to incur some inflammation in your workout, of course, in order for you to recover properly. That's the whole point of damaging your muscles, right? It's because then you want them to recover, so if you have no inflammation, it's gonna hinder the hypertrophy. And my tasty 3 fish oils. Eating vegetables first in your meal will help slow the digestion of carbs and reduce the insulin spike. So you start off with vegetables like salad, and then you go on to protein and fats next, and then finally you end with carbs. And that's how you can reduce any insulin spike, blood sugar spike, and not have a blood sugar crash afterwards. I forgot to mention that if it's a high carb day, I'll take this stuff. It's freaking awesome because it actually helps you stay lean. It's basically a glucose disposal agent. It's got berberine in it. So if you've ever heard of bodybuilders that tend to have their insulin resistance creep up because they're either eating a lot of carbohydrates or they're taking GH or maybe a growth hormone secretagogue, then they'll normally take something like this. And even Matt Jensen, who was the coach of, I'm brain farting right now because I'm just tired, but coach of the cousin who's the one who coached Chris Bumstead, he has his athletes take berberine and metformin as well. And basically all the anecdotal evidence shows that it doesn't affect your muscle building through the mTOR pathway to any significant degree, especially if you're running stuff anyways. So that's on the high carb day, which isn't today. Today is a normal carb day. And then this is what the pills look like. Oh, they're like cute little huge capsules. This is the support. Look how cute that is. Wow, it's got fucking huge written on it. You guys are so artistic. Wow. Whatever. Anyways, so I got this issue. I have this little obsession, right? And I blame my friend Lexi for this one. But before her, I used to have this crazy obsession, anyways, with stevia, right? I have confession. I'm addicted to sugar-free sweeteners. And that shit is dang. So, I got Stir. By the way, I'm not sponsored by any of these. I just like these. But these Stir things, these packets, whatever they're called, droplets that you can get from Amazon are fucking gas. You got black cherry, grape acai, fruit punch, peach mango, and then best of all, pineapple coconut. And I don't know where that one went because I just stuff in my pocket, bring it everywhere with me, so I lost it. And these are fire, dude. These Skittles packets, these go crazy. Focus, yeah. These go crazy. Favorite flavor for me, kiwi lime, and then second one is probably strawberry starfruit. Wait, no, pineapple passion fruit is actually really, really good. But I feel like it would be better if passion fruit was replaced with coconut. Without a doubt, though, without a doubt, this stuff has like rad 40 and rad 50 and rad 60 and rad 70. Yellow 5, red 40, yellow 5, blue 1. Yeah, they got a whole host of fucking colors in this shit. So I just finished a cold ass shower, and before I go in the shower, I normally drink a little bit of caffeine, since caffeine increases the dopamine receptor availability in your brain. So it doesn't actually increase your serum dopamine levels, but increases the sensitivity. So going in a super cold shower, ice cold shower, or even going into something like an ice bath is going to increase your dopamine levels, and it's not going to reduce the baseline at which you return back to after your dopamine levels rise, which is super nice, which is why cold therapy is just super effective at just getting yourself going. So in the mornings, two hours after I'll wake up, then I'll go drink a little bit of caffeine and then jump in the shower, do an ice cold shower. Wakes me the fuck up, listen to some bangers, and we're ready to go. Before I go to the gym on 2 days of the week, so on one leg day and on one chest and tricep day, I take this one unnatty thing. And I get it from the HRT clinic. And it's this. IGF-1 LR3. Ooh, focus on that baby. Yeah, IGF-1 LR3. So that's insulin-like growth factor. This is LR3, not DES. So technically DES is known and assumed to work a little bit better localized, but people still inject this right into the muscle that you want to work out so you can improve your proportions. Before, I would normally hit the gym when I do this, I basically consume a large amount of fast-acting carbs. I've been recommended to take something such as like fast-acting instant oats, like stuff that you normally wouldn't eat when you're focused on your glycemic index or your blood sugar, just fucking some fast-acting glucose. So consuming something like that, what other examples are there? I mean, you could have cyclic dextrin. What else you could have? White rice is probably okay, but it's not quite as fast as the other options. Like, honestly, you could just eat sugar. And then I mentioned this before, but since we're talking about this right now, I will take this 2 hours after my last meal before bed, and it'll be basically, it's a growth hormone secretagogue. It's tesmerelin compounded with epimerelin. And tesmerelin, honestly, if you had to choose between tesmerelin and MK, if you're not someone that needs to increase your hunger in drastic amounts, tesmerelin all the way, for sure. So I'm having a little snack that's a combination of black and brown rice and brown, black, and red quinoa. And I'm just gonna splash about 2 grams of olive oil in there, just so it tastes yummy. I got some fucking sexy fats. And then I'm gonna powder up this thing with some buttery garlic salt. This thing is fire. Not sponsored, but it's fire. So right now, I think someone stole my shoulder pad from my Cloud outfit for Final Fantasy VII. So now I'm gonna just search Amazon, see if I can find another one for cheap. But cause I still have to figure out what I'm gonna wear for Halloween. I've got my Vegito costume. I think I'm gonna rock that today. But I've already rocked it and I just want to use the Cloud sword. But the other option is I could also try to turn this into like a Guts costume from Berserk. Or I could try to be Zabuza from Naruto. Or he has a different sword. His sword's a lot smaller, so I couldn't really use it, but I could kind of try to make like a Trunks outfit if I can find like a purple jacket. I could be like future Trunks from Dragon Ball Z. So meal two, it's gonna be 100 grams of salmon. And then just cause it tastes so fucking good, we got the best milk in the world. Fairlife skim. I'm lactose intolerant, so this is the only milk other than like lactate that I find I can drink. And I'm going to do half a cup, which is 7 grams of protein, 3 grams of carbs, 0 grams of fat. A juicy scoop of this whey. This is the huge whey, because it tastes dank. So I personally like to put less milk in there, because if I mix it up with just a little bit less liquid, it kind of comes out to like a thicker, like pudding-like consistency, which just ends up feeling like it's like a sweet treat dessert for me, but I'm still staying on plan. If I really want it to be like a pudding, I'll put like just a quarter of a cup. But this one I put closer to a half cup, so it's gonna be more like a drink. Finally adding a little bit, 100 grams of white rice, just cause this is gonna be the pre-workout meal. And then for the supplements for this one, I'm gonna take this thing I got from Amazon, which is Zenwise, just digestive enzymes. Take one. And then I'm taking half this serving of Vital, which is Huge's best blood pressure medication. Not medication, it's a supplement. And then I'm gonna take a half serving of a magnesium malate. It's a nice magnesium for the muscles, especially since I'm about to go to the gym right after this digests. One more serving, which is just 2 pills of fish oil with this as well. Whey protein in the Fairlife milk, and then 100 grams of salmon, 100 grams of rice with some buttery garlic salt, and then 2 fish oils. So since it's gonna be a couple hours at least before the workout, I'm gonna be taking this, which is what the coach is having the athletes take. This is the most effective antioxidant that can be found in your body. So this is basically something that bodybuilders will get in IV form from 3 to 5 grams, say about approximately every month. But of course, this totally varies. And the great thing about having an injection, honestly, is like, I hate IVs. I don't know about you guys, but I don't want to get a fucking needle stuck in my vein. So I would prefer to just, you know, use a smaller needle if possible. You can find them super easily at HRT clinics, just like Transcend, the clinic that I'm with. And I would prefer this over IV. So since I'm about to go to the gym, I'm eating right now just a banana. I do like to have it frozen. I know it's really weird, but for some reason, frozen fruits just taste a little better to me. I feel like it's like ice cream or something. This thing is great, but every time I open it, it's... And then this, I don't actually take until I get to the gym, but once I get in, then I pop those pills. It's a big ass serving though, so if you can't take a lot of pills, it's probably not something you'll enjoy. But I love it.
So I just did a few warm-up sets of lat pull-downs. And for the engine workout, I'm gonna be putting 2 of these scoops of Super Carb.
This is retinidone though, and it makes you more sore. So if you get really sore after your workouts and you don't like it, it's probably not a good idea. But if you think you can handle the soreness and you feel like you're fucking growing, it's pretty epic. They're not necessary, but for sure, if you're lacking a pump, they'll get you it. So to be completely real with you guys, I am an hour behind my meals right now because that workout went a little bit longer than expected. It took me a little bit longer to get here. But the post-workout, I'm just doing two scoops of huge isolate. It's about 30 grams of protein, so just a little bit under, it turns out to be about 55 grams of protein. There's a reason why I like weigh isolate just in my trunk, because then I can just get it in as fast as possible, digest super quickly, especially when I'm late on my meals. And you know what they say, if you dry scoop protein, you get bigger 10% faster and you get lung disease. Alright homies, so this is where we're standing right now after those two scoops of whey and a whopping amount of scoops of supercarb. Two more than my coach wants me to. I'm gonna be real with you guys. I have a little secret thing that isn't technically on my program, but sometimes I replace some rice with it. It's these babies. I don't know why I love these so much. I don't know. I just like snacking on things, so I prefer to honestly just put this stuff in a bowl and snack on it rather than eating a whole meal. Like, and I think this is something that's ingrained in my genome because I remember when I was a little kid, my mom would always just enjoy eating Cheetos and tortilla chips and just anything that she could just pick out of a bag and munch on. And I don't know how I got this. It wouldn't make sense. I just feel like it wouldn't make sense that I got it through nurture. Like, I feel like this, like, is something that runs in our blood. In our blood. So, I already had 40 grams of pretzels when you guys weren't looking. And I'm gonna have another 25 in this bowl. So that's 75 grams of pretzels. Ends up being about 56 grams of carbs. Nice. So pretzels aren't really the best thing to eat. They are highly processed, and they are also very high in the glycemic index. I think they're about 86. So they're not really the best choice bodybuilding wise. But I mean, hey, if you ate it right around your workout, then you have a good argument for why you should be eating carbs with a high glycemic index. So this one is a mix of my white basmati rice and the brown black rice and red rice, red quinoa. The black and brown rice with the mixed colors of quinoa. So if you guys are wondering what rice that is. It's this. This is planet rice. So, yeah, black, red, and white quinoa with wild rice and sprouted brown rice. It's a hefty baby. And it's nice. Has a lot of fiber in it. Most bodybuilders wouldn't like this too much if they're eating like upwards of like 5,000 calories. Luckily, since I have a low metabolism and I can get fat easily, and I can also absorb calories easily, I only have to eat 3,200 calories to meet my needs. This is the white basmati rice that I eat. In addition to this beautiful cup of brown and white rice, we're gonna take the second half of the servings of these babies. Second half of the serving of this boy. Second half of the serving of this boy. And then three more fish oil pills. While I'm here, I'm just gonna prepare my last meal, which is gonna be a kind of like a protein ice cream pudding mixed with collagen that I love making. Ends my day with the last bit of protein I need to. So this is what I'm gonna do: quarter cup of Fairlife milk, 60 milliliters. Then, not sponsored by them, but 2 scoops of Vital Proteins chocolate collagen. Oh yeah. And then finally, I mix these juicy babies. Graham cracker, huge vegan protein. I'm gonna take about 2/3 of a scoop of this. And then huge whey protein. I'm gonna take a scoop of this baby. You see how that shit starts looking like cake batter? Fire. I wish you guys could literally taste this right now. So now that he's done, normally I would put him in the freezer, but since we're gonna have like 2-3 hours until I eat this guy, I'm gonna put him in my fridge with the fridge on high, the very top. It's gonna get pretty hard. And I'll either just leave it there, or if it's not hard enough, I'll just take it out, put it in the freezer before I have to eat it, like 10 minutes before, or like 15 minutes before, and it's perfect. Finally, with this chicken, salmon, and avocado bowl, I'm going to finish off my carbs with an apple. This totally goes against the whole fast acting high glycemic index carbs before bed, but normally I try to make myself have an apple a day, and I didn't have it yet. So, but the oats are nice because oats release some natural melatonin in your system, help you go to sleep even more. And oats, just like apples, are all both good for reducing your LDL.
Or it makes me never get fat, which is something I would hear quite often, which is not true.
So before I go to bed, I take these last two things: magnesium glycinate, which I get from Amazon, I'll probably link it in the description, and then finally ashwagandha, and I can link this in the description too, because this has been really helping me get really, really good sleep, and I feel really good in the mornings and don't have crazy anxiety. But you do gotta cycle it. I do gotta cycle it. So I do 2 weeks on, 2 weeks off. The reason I'm wearing these glasses is because these are my nighttime glasses and they block out a wide spectrum of blue light, and because I look fucking sick in them. And yeah, they block out blue light, so they help up my melatonin. Boop. The place where I get all my goodies from. So the Anavar Trosh is the IGF-1, the growth hormone secretagogues like tesamorelin, epimorelin, GHRP agonists, freaking all the good stuff, BPC. That's all from my HRT clinic. And you can probably get them from other HRT clinics, but I get mine from mine because it's like the bodybuilding clinic works with other bodybuilders like Phil Heath. So I love them and they've been helpful, but you can get them from anywhere. If you do get them from mine and you do end up using my link in my description, it does get me a commission. So just a heads up, if you don't like me, then don't use that link. Same thing with the discount codes for Niall and Huge. If you don't like me, don't use the discount code. There's other people that have discount codes. But if you do, it will help me buy a new set of these glasses because I broke them. So I put table in them. Anyways, love you, homies. I'll see you guys next time.